I like living and working in this space. The idea of taking something that's been disused and discarded and then making it into a living space. And here, all the artists are creating their own individual environments. So if you go into each studio, they all look very different. This studio looks like the Boudoir. And outside, you've got all these different objects and shapes, the mixture of the old and the new. So you've still got the industrialisation of East End in this space. And then you've got all the new bits. Yeah. The women who wear my designs are women who appreciate what I do. They can see what I make and they think it's beautiful. I'm trying to challenge the kind of fetish imagery that we have, which tends to be based on very recycled ideas like the military, the aviator, you know, the equestrian thing. And a lot of the fashion that we have as far as fetish fashion comes from that very, very masculine aspect. The items that I'm working on is all about being who you want to be. One of the liberating things about the fetish scene is the fact that we have the choice to dress in whichever way we choose. In a lot of civilizations, they've used leather. In all civilizations, they've used leather. It's the oldest material. Skin has always been there. And the idea of taking something that's dead and making it beautiful again, and it's almost like reincarnation. You're taking something that's dead and you're giving it birth again. And I think it's really important that, in the same way that songs are passed down, that crafts are passed down from one generation to another. So education, you know, is important to me. I want to be able to teach people to make what I'm making, because otherwise those skills disappear. The economy, if it picks up, will only pick up if people in this country start buying off makers in this country. It might be more expensive, but then it's made here. But you know, I mean, it's almost like there is a fair trade to do with the rest of the world, and I always feel that there should be almost like a fair trade for the workers and the designers in this country. Quality is everything, and you've got to, a lot of the designers and makers here love what they do, they have a passion for what they do. So they're not going to produce items that are shoddy. You're a designer and a maker because you have a passion for it, not because you are there to make money. Otherwise you wouldn't be doing it. There are easier ways of making money than punching holes for 5 hours. So the designers and the makers in this country have a passion for doing it, and that's why their items are better quality, because otherwise they wouldn't do it. They do it because they love doing it.
Thank you.
Thank you.